Welcome to Nagesh Karasgi Orchid School channel. Myself Priscilla Asade. Today I am going to teach you English grammar. That is lesson number 13, pronouns part 2. So students, do you remember what we have learned in the last session? Yes, we have learned the same lesson. That is lesson number 13, pronouns part 1. Yes, in that what we have finished? Yes, we have learned about pronouns and possessive pronoun. What is pronoun, students? Yes, pronouns is used in place of nouns, and possessive pronouns means what? Possessive pronouns means that belongs to somebody or something or somebody. Okay, and I have told you what are the words used for possessive pronouns. Okay, so before starting this lesson, that is the part 2, what we are going to learn in this part 2, we are going to learn personal pronouns, singular and plural pronoun, and gender. As we have learned in nouns, singular and plural noun, genders, possessive nouns, all these we have learned in noun lesson. The same way we are going to learn in pronoun also, all these parts. So shall we start, students? Okay, open Fun with Grammar book, lesson number 13, pronoun, page number 41. So before we start, again I'll take one recap of this lesson. Okay, so what is the definition? It is just a recap. Again, I am telling you, students, this is a recap what we have learned in part 1. So pronouns are used for or in place of nouns. Okay, some common pronouns I told you which you have to learn and you have to remember. Okay, that was I, me, we, us, he, him, it, them, you, she, her, they. Okay, mine, yours, ours, his, hers, and this are called possessive pronouns. These are the possessive pronouns. So some words were included in pronouns and some words were included in possessive pronouns. Now you may be thinking, teacher, how we have to use all these pronouns? So that we are going to learn in our today's session. Okay, so first is, what is that which we are going to learn? That is personal pronoun. Now, what is personal pronoun? We will understand that. So, the definition of personal pronouns are the pronouns used in place of people, animals, and things. Again, I'll repeat, personal pronouns are the pronouns used in place of people, animal, and things. Now, these pronouns have different forms, okay, that we are going to see. Okay, in your book it is on page number 41, but just look on the slide, what is there? Pronouns have different forms, that is first person, second person, and third person. Now what is this? Okay, first person means myself, the speaker. When I am talking to someone, for example, if I am talking to you and your name is Ram and your friend name is Ravi, now if I will say, how are you, Ram? So, I am the speaker, I am the first person. You are Ram, you are second person. Now, for example, Ravi is absent and I just want to ask you about Ravi. So, I will ask you, Ram, where is Ravi? So, Ravi is here, the third person. Understood, student? First person means the speaker, second person means the person we are speaking to. Okay, to whom we are speaking, and third person, the person about whom we are speaking. Maybe the third one, that person is not here, he is absent, and I am asking that one to be the second person. So understood what is first person, second person, and third person? Again, I'll repeat, students, first person is nothing but the speaker, those who are speaking, and to whom we are speaking, the person we are speaking to whom I am speaking, okay, that is a second person. And if I want to have some message about someone, or I want to ask about someone, so the third person is that one. So the person about whom we are speaking, okay, so that is third person. Now in this, if it is a first person, so which is the pronouns we are going to use? Yes, I, me, we, us. See, this table is very important. It will help you to understand who is the first person, who is the second person, and who is the third person. Again, I'll repeat. What are the pronouns used for the first person? I, me, we, and us. What are the pronouns used for the first person, students? Yes, I, me, we, and us. For second person, there is no need to bahat it. It is only one pronoun. That is Y, O, U, U. Now, third person. So, what are the pronouns used for the third person, students? Yes, he, him, she, her, they, them, and it. Again, I'll repeat. What are the pronouns used for the third persons? Again and again, I'm not going to say the name. I'm going to use some pronouns. So, what are that? He, him, she, her, they, them, and it. For this block also, you make it a star. Okay? So that you can learn this. Okay? The important is these words. Okay? So, understood what are the words used for the first person, second person, third person? What are the pronouns used for? Okay? So, on basis of these words only, we are going to solve exercise A. Now, I hope that you have understood what is personal pronoun. Now, we will move on to singular and plural pronoun. As we have learned in noun lesson, what is singular noun and what is plural noun. So, same way in pronoun also it is there. That is just like nouns, pronouns can be singular and or plural. Okay. Now, we will see what is singular pronouns and what is plural pronouns. Okay. So, if a noun is single, we are going to use I and me. Again, I will repeat, students, if it is a singular pronoun, we are going to use I and me. If it is plural, we are going to use we and us. Okay, students, same. If it is single, we are going to use Y, O, U. And if it is plural, again we are going to use the same word Y, O, U. Here there is no difference even if it is singular or even if it is plural. It will not change. It will remain same. Y, O, U. And can you tell me, students, Y, O, U is which person? Yes, it is a second person. This is first person. Yes or no? Which we have learned in personal pronouns. Now next, she, her. Okay, so this is a singular pronoun. She and her. She and her is what, students? Yes, it is a third person. And if it is in plural pronoun, we are going to use the word they and them. Now, he, him, it, it. Here five are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sorry. She, her, he, him, and it. Okay. And if it is plural pronoun, we are going to use they and them. This box is in your book, page number 43. This also you make it a star. See, whenever I am telling you to make it star, means that you have to learn. You have no option for that. Understood, students? Okay. Then now next, what we are going to learn? Yes. We are going to learn genders. Do you remember in gender lesson what we have learned? Yes, we have learned masculine, feminine, common, and neuter gender. This already you know. For male gender, we are telling it as masculine gender. For female, we are telling it feminine. If both are included, that is common. And if non-living things is there, we are going to use it as neuter gender. Now, in this gender, means just like nouns, pronouns to have genders. How it is, we will see. Now, see the four columns. Can you see, students, the four columns? Masculine, feminine, common, and neuter. Now, in masculine column, what will come? Yes, he and him. See, if Ram is there, Ravi is there, when any name is given in the passage or in sentence, you can make out that is it a name of a male or female, and according to that you can put the gender. For example, I have told you, if it is masculine, that is masculine gender, you are going to use the pronoun he and him. Now, if it is feminine gender, if for example Tina, Rina, or many names which you can recognize that it is a female, that time you are going to replace it with the pronoun she and her. Common, I, we, me, us, you. Here there is nothing we can include a masculine also, feminine also. For example, I have taught you in gender, what comes under common? Yes, doctor, students, yes or no? We can't make it out that is it masculine or feminine. So as it is common, we are going to use I, we, me, us, you. And IT, it, neuter, represents the non-living things. So we are going to use the pronoun IT, it. Hope students you have understood what is genders. Okay, so how pronouns to have genders. Do you want me to repeat it again students? I hope that you have understood. It is very simple. Now what we are going to do students? Yes, tell me. Yes, we are going to solve the exercise. Okay, open page number 42 from your book, that is Fun with Grammar book. Open page number 42, Fun with Grammar book, exercise D. I hope that you are having pencil with you. Okay, see, whatever I have taught you, now personal pronouns, singular and plural pronouns, and genders, and I have told you there are some pronouns which you have to bahar. So when we are solving this, you have to just refer to that tables which I have told you to make it a star. So are you ready students? Page number 42, exercise D. Okay, now exercise D, actually I'll give you homework, but I'll just explain you what you have to do. You just write it here HW, but try in your rough book, not here. Again I'll repeat you that this HW you have to write in rough book, you have to write in your own sentence, but I'll explain you how you have to do. Now what is your exercise G? I think we in the last session we have finished till exercise C, so we are going to start with exercise G. When you reached home, you said, mother, luck was my byside today. Now think about your lucky day and write about it in the first person. Now you know what is the words used in first person? This, yes, means you are the speaker. I, me, we, us. Only these words you are going to use in this passage. Now what you are going to write in this passage? What is there? Mother, luck was by my side today. Means, for example, your teacher has told you one test in class, okay, and you are not at all prepared with that because of some or the other reason. Now you reach school in class. Now you are just waiting for that period, that if for example maths test is there, now you are waiting for maths period. Now maths teacher will come, she'll take the test, and then I will be unable to solve because some or the other reason. Now what happened that day? Test is there, but ma'am is absent. Yes or no? Then what you will feel? You will be very happy and you will say, "Arey, what a lucky person I am. So the sentence is, that time you'll go home and tell your mother, mother, luck was by my side. Now this thing you have to write in the passage. So how you are going to write? Just write in your rough book. Try it. Anyhow, I'll send you in PDF. Okay. So now we'll move on to exercise E. Open exercise E. It is open only, I'll just read out. Okay. Now here what we have to do students? Read that. Underline the pronouns. What is the first thing we have to do? First you have to recognize the pronouns. Okay. And then what you have to do? And write against each sentence the form of pronoun or person used. For example, state whether it is in the first person, second person or third person. Understood students what we have to do? Again I'll repeat. First you have to underline the pronoun, and when you are underlining the pronoun, afterwards you have to write, is it in the first person, is it in a second person, or is it in a third person. I have told you that block, that table, you have to bahat it, so it will help you to write over here. Are you ready students? Okay. Now I am talking to one of my friends. So what is the first sentence? lions are royal animals. Okay, and they are called the king of the jungle. Now here if we'll see, we can see that what is the pronoun?
Yes,
T-H-E-Y, they. Can you see here they? Now can you tell me, students, what is they? Which person it is?
Yes, it is a third person. So just write here, third person. Okay.
Okay, first I have underlined and then I have written it is in which person, that is a third person. Next, I like the cakes made by mother. So what is the pronoun here? I means it is a first. So I will write here first person. Nothing you have to do. Next, you are such a soft spoken person. So you, underline, I am telling you. So you is a second person to whom I am speaking. Their house is spacious. It is so beautiful and well kept. Means I am talking about the third person's house. So there and it is a third person. If you feel it difficult, you can write here number 1, 2, 3 like this, first person, second, and but afterwards you have to complete it. I am just giving you shortcut so that you can finish it along with me. Now fifth, we are going to the golden temple. We means I am going along with my friends. So we is a speaker, that is a first person. My mother cooked delicious food for us. Yes, us, that is first person. While writing this, you have to just refer to the table which is given on page number 41. She makes special food for Anik every day. She makes, so it's a third person. I am talking about the third person. The speaker is telling to the second person about the third person, that she makes special food for Anik every day. You should maintain a collection of old stamps. You means the speaker is telling to someone, so you is a second person. I joined school on the first day of the new session. Yes, I joined school on the first day of the new session. I means speaker. I am telling. So I am first person. Hope students, you are writing along with me. Be fast. Cows are herbivores. They eat grass, leaves and vegetables. So I am talking about cow, that is they, that is a third person. Hope students, you have finished with all the 10 examples. Just have a look, just check your answer. If you have not finished, make it a shortcut, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then you have to complete it as I have written on the board. Okay, shall we move on to exercise F, students? Now just read what is in exercise. What is the instructions given? I hope that you have completed with this exercise. Chalo, ready. We'll move on to exercise F. Fill in the blanks with the correct form of personal pronouns. Again, I'll say students, fill in the blanks with the correct form of personal pronouns. Here we can see that here personal pronouns we have seen first person, second person, third person. So all those words will come over here. For example, I, me, we, us, you, he, him, she, her, they, them and it. Now depending upon the sentence, when we'll read the sentence, automatically you'll come to know which pronoun we have to use. Please come here, dash want to talk to you. Means the speaker is calling to someone. So please come here, I want to talk to you. Come and tell dash what happened. Come and tell whom? Me. Okay, so which pronoun? Me. My mother told dash about my great grandfather. So my mother told whom? Me only. So these are all in the first person, the speaker is speaking. So we are going to use the personal pronouns of the first person. Okay. Now Rita is my best friend and dash is absent today. Okay. So you are telling your teacher or you are telling one of your friend. So what word you are going to use? Rita is my best friend. As Rita is a which gender? Yes, it is a female gender, feminine gender. So I am going to use the word she. I have a question for each one of dash. If teacher is telling, teacher is a speaker and she is telling to the students. So I have a question for each one of the person to whom we are speaking. So that is Y-O-U. I have told you for the second person we are going to use only one word, that is Y-O-U. Our teacher told dash that we should not eat outside daily. Now teacher told who? Us. The third person. They talk to dash only when they want me to do something for dash. Now they talk to whom? Me. Only when they want me to do something for whom? Already it is they will turn into them. I hope students you have finished whatever I have written over here. Now I will move on to the next, that is page number 43, 8, 9, 10. You solve it on your own. Chalo, read the sentence and put the correct personal pronouns which you feel over there. Rita and I are good friends. Now here students we can see that Rita and I, it is a plural, so we are going to use we, W-E-V. We study in the same school. My mother was worried about me. Their class teacher was angry with them. And in this way we have finished with our personal pronouns. Now we are going to solve singular and plural nouns, pronouns and genders. Here come on to exercise G. As we have learned about singular and plural pronouns, we will just solve this exercise G. Show whether the pronouns are singular, plural. S for singular, P for plural, M for male, F for female, N for neuter and C for common. Example. Now one example they have done, how we have to solve this exercise. Now she. Now what do you feel she? She is a singular. And you can make out that she comes under which gender? It is feminine gender. So singular, that is S, and feminine means F. Okay, now what you have to do, whatever bold words are there, that you have to just see whether it is in singular or plural. If it is singular, write S. If it is plural, write P. And afterwards, we can see, we are going to write M, F, N or C. He is singular. Okay, and as it is male, I am going to write M. She is also singular, but it is a female, feminine gender, so I am going to write him is also singular, but it is male. Understood, students? So this way, again, next, she, so I will go fast, she is singular, F is female, that is feminine gender, F. Again, he is singular, F. H E he is male, so I am going to write M. Now W E V is what? Yes, it is plural. Now it is male or female? Yes, it is as it is given over here, it is ladies, so I am going to write here female, that is feminine gender. Please come to her. Yes, this is also singular, her is feminine, so I will write F. We, the students, have called him today. We is also plural. Students comes under which gender? Yes, it comes under common gender. Have called him. It is singular and him is male. Understood, students? Okay. Now we will move on to H. Filling the blanks with suitable personal pronouns. Okay. Dash are late for the test. Yes. So we are going to write here Y-O-U. Meena and Tina play badminton. Dash practice in the evening. As Meena and Tina are plural, so I am going to use they. This story is very interesting. Dash should read it. Yes. You, second person, should read it. Dash are going to Goa this weekend. Yes, we are going to Goa this weekend. Can you pass me the sugar, please? And in this way we have finished whatever we have learned, that is we have learned personal pronouns, singular and plural pronouns, and we have learned about gender. I have solved all the exercise and I hope that you have understood and you have copied down, because it was very only three words it was. I'll just take a recap what we have learned in part 1 and part 2. Are you ready, students? Okay, we'll just have a recap about what we have learned in this was the thing which we have learned in last session.
The doctor gave Ravi medicine. Ravi feels that if Ravi takes the medicine regularly, Ravi will recover soon. Don't you think it sounds awkward? Now let us read these sentences. Ravi has not come to school today. He is not well. He visited the doctor yesterday. The doctor gave him medicine. Ravi feels that if he takes the medicine regularly, he will recover soon. The noun Ravi has been replaced by he and him. He and him are pronouns. Pronouns are used for or in place of nouns. A pronoun makes a sentence simpler and shorter. It is easy to read and understand. Examples: he, she, it, they. Let us understand the correct use of it. Example: the donkey fell down because the donkey was tired. The donkey fell down because it was tired. Pronoun it has replaced two words, the and donkey. Some common pronouns are I, me, we, us, he, him, it, you, she, her, they, them. This pen is mine. No, it is not yours. It is his. Sorry, the pen is actually hers. Mine, yours, ours, his, hers, and theirs are called possessive pronouns because they show that something belongs to somebody. Read the following sentences to understand the use of different possessive pronouns. The book belongs to me. The book is mine. The book belongs to you. The book is yours. Personal pronouns. Personal pronouns are the pronouns used in place of people, animals, and things. Persons. Pronouns have different forms. First person, second person, third person. The speaker. I, me, us, we. The person we are speaking to. You. The person about whom we are speaking. He, him, she, her, they, them, it. Singular and plural pronouns. Just like nouns, pronouns can be singular or plural. Singular pronouns, I, me, you, she, her, him, he, him, it. Plural pronouns, we, us, you, they, them, genders. Just like nouns, pronouns do have genders. Masculine, he, him. Feminine, she, her. Come, I, we, me, us, you. Neuter, it. Pronouns, they, them, are used for males, females, and even neuter genders. Value corner. Every year, you play the role of Hanuman in Ramana. But this year, the selectors choose your friend in place of you. Will you discontinue your friendship with him or help him prepare for the role?
Okay, in this way students, we have finished our lesson number 13, pronouns in two parts, that is part 1 and part 2. So today whatever we have learned, along with that I have shown you a recap of part 1 also. So what we have finished students, we have finished pronouns, we have finished possessive pronouns, we have finished personal pronouns, we have finished with singular and plural pronouns and genders. Hope so students, you have understood this lesson in detail. Thank you, have a good day.